So me and Brookie are going on our first little road trip together. We got some chips and salsa because it's Cinco de Mayo. I'm guiding tomorrow, so I just worked on my trailer a little bit this morning and finished clearing off the whole back wall and went and got some expanding foam that I'm gonna use to seal all the holes that you can see daylight through the outside. This way no spiders can get in because I really don't like spiders and I've seen them in my trailer before, so they're getting in somehow and I really think it's that way. But anyway, so we're gonna go fishing today and I'm gonna try and get Brookie on her first brook trout. I feel like the first fish that we catch while hanging out needs to be a brook trout since her name is Brookie. So we made it to our fishing spot. It's 4:30, so I don't have a ton of time to fish. I'm gonna try and get Brookie on her first brook trout. She's ready to go. She didn't really like the dirt road, but hey, you know, she needs to get used to that for sure. But I'm just gonna rush up there and try and get her on some fish, so we'll see how it goes. Just gonna feed her real quick before we go so she's all relaxed. Girl, you are gonna fall off the tailgate back up. This is dangerous, kitty. Hold on. Hold on, hold on. You gotta back up. You gotta back up, baby. There you go. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's the good stuff. All right, easy, easy on the bottle. What you doing with your arm? You're a good kitty. This little girl just got her first brook trout. So proud of her. She's a little mad at me because I grabbed a fish and then my hand was wet and then I grabbed Brookie and I got her a little wet. Right, Brookie? She didn't really like that. Then I had to warm her up in a blanket. Hey, come on. We're going fishing. Come on. Good girl. Come on. Oh, that's my girl. Yeah, come on, baby. Come on. Whoa, she's so fast. Come on, Brooke. Come on, Brookie. Oh. All right, so it's windy as heck. Me and Brookie tried a lake first, and it was just so windy, and the fish weren't biting anything. I literally tried every fly that normally works, and they just weren't biting. So we decided to hit this little creek and catch some native Colorado. Stay here, Brookie. Here it is. Little dude. And a little nymph. Let me clean him off. We just got another one, right, Brookie? Brookie! Beautiful little guy. All right. Alright, Brooke. Should we get another fish?
Yeah?
Yeah? Where's my yes? Come on. That works. Alright, we're gonna catch some more fish on dry flies. And then we gotta go guide. Alright, Brooke. Come on. Come on. The fish are over here. Come on. That's my girl. Good girl. We're almost there. Keep coming. Come on. Good girl. All right, Brookie. This is the spot, okay? You stay there by my toes. Okay, on my toes. Now now she's being good in the pouch. She was giving some really scary cries when the wind blew really, really bad. So now that she's in the pouch, she seems to be content. I feel like a kangaroo mama. Right, Brookie. She's like, I'm just chilling. I'm a fishing kitty. Alright, just got another one. Come here, Brooke. Come here, Brooke. Look, fishy. Come here. What is that? What is that? Look. Look at that. Whoa. Okay, she's not interested. Little beauty. All right, letting them go. Okay, as you can see, there's some pieces out to be painted. Look at all the scraps. This is what it looks like now. I haven't been filming for the past couple days just because I've been working on it so much. So we got new wood for the cabinets and I lined them. Everything's apart over here. This beige is what this whole section is going to be painted here in these two side walls. We've been cutting insulation and putting in new insulation. And look how cool that wall's going to look. It's going to be so cool. It's going to go from there around the window all the way up to the top and stop right there. So that is going to be awesome. We filled in all the holes with spackle and wood filler. Right now I've just been cleaning this. So I just cleaned that one. This is what it used to look like. Just super dirty. Gross. So this is what it looks like after. Way better. Bathroom is entirely gutted. This is going to be covered. And this is going to be a closet. And this is going to be painted beige as well. Let's see. What else? Oh, the floor. So we found out that there is a section of the floor right here that was totally rotted. So we decided to get these half-inch plywood to make a sturdy floor. And we're going to put this on top. So that's going to be on the ground. That's going to be on the walls. This is going to be the back, and it's going to be stained. The color's called toffee. It's going to look so sweet. I'm so excited. There's going to be carpet right here for my Brookie. And a bed will be right here. It's going to be awesome. I got a dark green for the accent color that I'm going to do along all the trim. And everything else will be beige. So it's going to be really cool. I'm super excited. Progress. So this is what the wall looks like, all finished. All the way up to the ceiling. We just have to put one more little piece there and cut it. So pretty. Going to stain it now. This is my favorite piece. I love the color and the texture. So that's going to be stained. Then there's going to be window trim. I filled in all the little nail holes with wood putty. You can't even see them. And that has the first coat on it. Starting to look good. Let's see what it looks like after it's stained. Alright, so started staining it and it's coming along good. You can see there. I'm so in love with it. It looks great. I'm going to put this down and get some shots of me staining it. I'm rubbing the brush on it and then spreading it in with the sock so there's no brush strokes or anything. Look at that wall. Didn't do the ceiling yet, but I will. But oh my gosh, that looks awesome. I'm so happy with the way it turned out. And you can see so much texture and still a little bit of color in some of the pieces of wood. I'm gonna have to try and work on that spot a little bit. There was sap there. I got it all off, but this stain's still not going on. But look at that. Oh my gosh. I love it. Looks so good. Looks like a little trailer cabin, just like I wanted. And I love how light it is over here. It really makes it look bigger. All right, let me just show you the progress so far. So I painted all the trim the same dark green as everything else in the trailer. I just barely did that. I ended up using spray paint. So they all have two coats on them and they're all drying. And yeah, see, there's all these accessories, the cabinets. And once that's done, I'm gonna put them back on the inside the trailer. But right now I'm gonna take a break while those are drying and go to the gym. But in the meantime, look at how good it looks in here. So I put some polyurethane on the wall and the ceiling yesterday. Just gives it a little bit of a shine and really protects it against stains or spills or whatever. We finished doing the beige paint, two coats on everything. So that looks really good. So I'm going to put some trim in the edges, probably on the ground too, and around the window frame. And I'm gonna paint that the same dark green as everything else. Let's see what else. The closet is the only thing that's not fully painted, but I mean, that's gonna be a closet, so I'm not super worried about it. But besides that, everything is done. So it just needs to be vacuumed in here with the shop vac, and on my way home from the gym, I'm gonna stop at Home Depot and buy the flooring, which, whoa. This is the flooring. It goes really well with the wood, I think. So, and it goes good with the walls. So I need 56 squares of these, is what I calculated. So once I get that, I should be good to vacuum it and put it down. Put the doors and everything back in. And after that, it's gonna be framing the bed. But so far it's moving along pretty well. I'm excited. Hey guys, thanks for watching my third trailer vlog. There'll be another one posted tomorrow. I believe that'll end the series, but I'm gonna keep it going with some vlogs of just my daily life of actually living in my trailer, because that's what I do, and going fishing with my cat and all that fun stuff. But thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And also go check out fabellifestyle.com. I make these fly line bracelets. They're pretty cool. Go check it out. Thanks.